نحمد ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته بتوں سے تجھ کو امید ہے خدا سے نا امیدی بتا تو صحیح اور کافری کیا ہے. The meaning of these verses is that we have hopes with the idols, we have hopes with the false things, but we don't have hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The poet is asking, if this is not kufr, then what is kufr? We say, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. We repeat this many times, that there's no power to do good or to stay away from good, except with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to become firm on this. Believe that nothing happens until Allah wants. When Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani was advising his son, his wasiyya to his son, there are people who visit his grave today, but there are very few people who take his advice seriously. There are very few people who know what his preachings were. So he says, remember my son, لا فاعل في الحقيقة ولا مؤثرة إلا الله. There's no doer in reality. Nothing is effective until Allah wants. إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. Fire cannot burn you until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't approve. Water cannot drown you if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want. Poison cannot kill you until Allah wants. Nothing will benefit you until Allah allows it to benefit you. So why do you want to spread your hands at people's door when the door of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is open for you? When you believe that nothing happens except with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we should have hope with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should ask Him. We think that when we drink water, our thirst is quenched. But the water doesn't quench your thirst. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who quenches it. We think that the food eliminates hunger, but that's not how it happens. It's by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Think about Musa alayhi salam. He has taken his people along with him out of Egypt, and now they are stopped by the river, and they have in front of them water. They can't go the other way, and behind them they have Fir'aun and his people coming. And the Quran says, they said, Ya Musa, inna lamudrakun, that we have been caught. Where do we go now? But in Tawrat we learn that Bani Israel started fighting and arguing with Musa alayhi salam. Where did you bring us? At least we had life in Egypt. We had food and drink. Now what will happen to us? We are going to be punished severely. Musa alayhi salam says, Kalla inna ma'ya rabbi sayahdeen. No, I have my Lord with me and He will guide me. Now think about it. Tell me, where do you see a way? In front of you have water, behind you have Fir'aun and his army approaching to kill you and punish you. What is the way out? When we can't see a way to believe and have yaqeen in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He will help us, that is true iman. When we have money, we feel secure and we feel at peace. That means that we have hopes in our money, but we don't have hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It means that we don't have trust in Allah. We don't believe that Allah is the one who makes ways for everything. If we have this trust, that means we have iman. And if we don't have this trust, that means that we have iman or we have trust in material things. Where did the people of Bani Israel see a way? Physically, there was no way that Musa alayhi salam and his people would be saved. Saying huwa ma'akum ayna ma kuntum, saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with us wherever we are, is easy. But having yaqeen on this changes everything. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us this yaqeen, and we ask Him to strengthen our iman, especially during these times of fitna. Ameen wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك اللهم صل وسلم على نبينا محمد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته